Hello friends, in this video I am going to show you the new version of waterproof tracking device with wireless charging. This version is called VALTRACK-V4-MF-W. The major change in this design is the addition of the 4G LTE module, and the second major addition is the addition of Bluetooth 5.0 support. The SIM7500 module is used because of its small size, which fits in this enclosure, and it has the fallback for 2G and 3G networks in case the 4G network becomes unavailable. The MCU is changed to STM32WB55 MCU. This is an RF MCU, which is a multiprotocol wireless SoC, and it supports Bluetooth 5.0, Zigbee and Thread protocols. We added this because Bluetooth support is needed for communication with a smartphone for a device configuration. But apart from configuration, when we tested the device's Bluetooth range in beacon mode, it gave approximately 150 meters line of sight range with this onboard PCB antenna. This enables the device to be used for short range tracking applications without cellular, as the lost and find devices available in the market. The device can be attached to assets or pets with the Bluetooth turned on, and the phone is connected to the device all the time. Whenever the device gets out of the range, the app alerts the user on his phone saying your asset is moving away from you or you forgot the tracking device behind. Since the range is more than 100 meters, you can easily use it to prevent things from leaving your house compound. Even if it leaves, you can always track it with the cellular tracking option. So these are the major additions to the V2MFW design. We also got the stickers done for the device to facilitate viewing of LED from outside the enclosure. The LED will be visible from the top lid through these cutouts made. And this overlay or sticker will come on top of this cutouts on top of the enclosure so that we can view the LEDs through these transparent windows. We got a sticker done from two vendors. The first one is with fully transparent windows, and the second one is translucent white windows. And we observed that among these two type of stickers, the fully transparent one doesn't look so good due to the light appearing concentrated in one place of the icon. So we will go ahead with the translucent white stickers, which tend to distribute the light well. Otherwise, we should use some diffuser to spread the light evenly. These stickers are done for V2MFW, and we still need to get the V4MFW stickers done. The Bluetooth part of the STM32WB can be configured to run different profiles like beacon mode, heart rate mode and blood pressure device profile, etc. The STM32WB by default supports over-the-air firmware updates through the Bluetooth interface. The device supports wireless charging, and we have tested the device is able to charge the 750 mAh battery in 1 hour. We can increase the current still more, but 0.5C is the safe charging current for the lithium batteries. I observed that this small charging coil is also able to charge the battery at the same rate as the bigger coil. This is because the charge current is regulated, and this current is not exceeding the small charging coil's current rating. The challenge is to provide some kind of information to the user on how to align the device on the charging pad for optimum power transfer. We can design a charging pad circuit, but we won't be able to make good looking enclosures for it. V4MFW will also support the same operating modes as the other Valtrack devices, like the SMS tracking mode, the HTTP tracking mode and the MQTT over TCP tracking modes. It also has accelerometer on board, which is used for motion alerts and power consumption on inactivity. Since the SIM7500 supports GNSS, a UFL connector is added for this purpose so that an external active or passive antenna can be connected to it. By default, we will only use the onboard AC863K3L GNSS module, which is giving very good results. It is able to acquire GNSS signal within 30 seconds of boot up under open sky. thanks to the increased ground plane. We are planning to get Zephyr OS working on the V4MF making the firmware open source so that the device hardware is utilized to the fullest for different customized applications. I still don't know the ABC of Zephyr development, but I feel it could add great value for the VALTRACK device series portfolio. If anyone wants to help with the Zephyr development for V4MF, please contact me on the email address shared at the end of this video. This can be the basis for upcoming 4G, LTE and NB-IoT and LoRa supported devices. The vehicle tracking version of V4MF called V4MF-VTS is under development and is based on the SIM7600G 4G module with the global band support, which should work on any cellular network of any country. I'm trying to adopt SIM7600 to V4MF instead of the SIM7500, but it's slightly bigger for this enclosure. I will update you guys in the next video if I was able to successfully fit the 7600 into this. Here's a short clip on an Android app controlling an LED on the V4MFW board using the STM32WB Bluetooth interface. The other features of the V2MF all are migrated to V4MF, like the 1 megabit EEPROM, the wireless charger, the power MOSFETs for controlling the GSM and GPS on and off, the nano SIM connector, the SOS button for emergency alerts and entering the configuration mode, and the RGB LED driver and the flex connector. The flex connector will be used for connecting the programmer to the board. One addition you can see is the voltage level translator. TXS 0104 is added to support the 1.8 volt IO levels of the 7500 module. I'm happy to say that all the parts of the design are working well in first attempt, and the device is ready to use as is in normal tracking modes. Once I get the V4MFW stickers done, we'll put the device for sale on our online store. That's all the update on the V4MFW. We also made a Bluetooth module based on STM32WB55. It's a board mount module and is compatible with HM10 module pinout. We will get the transparent UART mode working in this and make the modules available for purchase. These Bluetooth 5.0 modules also give 150 plus meters of line of sight range. If you have any questions on the products, you can drop me a mail to ravi@valetron.com, and if you have any technical questions, you can post it on our forum www.embeddedadvice.com, and all of our products are available for purchase on our store valetron.com/store URL. That's all for now. Thank you for watching. Don't forget to like, share and subscribe.